listening, learning, looking. Okay. I think Don said he has a comment on behalf of somewhere on behalf
I have
of
a someone. Public comment, and I didn't know where else this might fit in the meeting, but this should be entitled Broadband Acronym of the Day. And I'm going to tell Paul that he's disqualified from this miniature contest. But what I would like to do is to compliment AT&T for the work they're doing in Puerto Rico. They have a flying drone that is helping restore telecommunications pending restoration of the infrastructure. And the name of this drone is the Flying COW. And to the first person other than Paul who can tell us what the acronym COW is, will win a prize.
Communications on Wings.
Close.
Well, in that setting, he's probably right.
It's usually
on
cell on wheels, but...
On wheels?
Yeah, usually a cow is cell on wheels, but this one's not on wheels.
So cell on wings?
Yes. John gets the prize.
Oh, there's a prize! Oh, there's
and
a prize!
Prize is the Chicago mix. Trademarked by the Minnesota Candyland Company.
So,
enjoy.
So, so here's the next question. John, are you coming back to the office this afternoon?
John, you are going back. Twice
now.
Well, I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I think we're probably going to be seeing more of that being used, particularly in California.
Yeah. It's fascinating. It's a tethered drone, which essentially is a short-term substitute for a collar. Very creative.
I also saw that and I thought, I might start paying attention to drone legislation around here now, just to make sure, you know, because you never know.
So, today's meeting, we'd like to do the Office of Broadband update in just a second here. Our main business before us is review this year's final report. But before we start that, I would like to say, well, I'll wait for the report part, because probably more people will come in, hopefully, by that time. But we have arrange for, and we'll take a pause in the meeting for 10:45. We have figured out how to hook into C-SPAN and see Senator Franken's core speech. I think most people probably would like to hear that speech, so we'll take a little pause in our meeting and hear that, and then we'll move forward.
With that, we've got just a quick update on the agenda. Today, and it dawned on me, we were in between. We had not announced the awards since the last time we met, so that really is the big news that's happened since we were here last, is that the announcement was made that 39 awards were made, just over $26 million in awards. And for knowing it's one of the first questions we get asked is that there were $20 million appropriated. The reason for being able to award over $26 million is because a couple of projects that came back and a small number of projects that came in under budget. So we were able to turn those dollars around and grant them back out. Some highlights of this list are all technologies are represented as far as terrestrial, non-mobile, is fiber, DSL, fixed wireless, cable, DOCSIS 3.0 are all represented in this list. All regions, as you see the map, you get a good sense that there was a good geographic dispersion of applications and awards. Some of the things that we're highlighting here is there are 9 new partners in this mix, which again, one of the policy objectives of the program was to work with providers all across the state to encourage them to branch out into areas that they weren't previously serving. So we consider 9 new partners a real win for the program this year. Of note this year is there's 2 tribal areas being served by projects, with Fond du Lac project and the Garden Valley Bijou project. In addition to the 9 new partners, we have a lot of partners who have gotten involved last year or the year before and realized that this made sense for them and was a valuable tool in their arsenal, so they came back with applications that proposed to expand the areas, the unserved areas they were serving from their original projects. And so that we think that's another Great thing to highlight. And then the one other piece that we highlight is there are at least two projects that have robust partnerships with townships. And townships are have shown to be passionate about this subject and good partners because they are obviously the closest elected officials to, you know, the areas that we are trying to serve here, the unserved areas. So that is, and I'm happy to take any questions about the grant program. I've got just a couple of other things on my list, and if you stop me at any time if you do have questions about the program itself. The second thing is sad news for us, but happy news for Jane Leonard, for those of you who didn't see it. She is leaving us in a couple of weeks, and as you all know, she is our grant administrator, and she's leaving to head up Growth and Justice, which is a policy and research organization focused on bolstering the Minnesota economy, and so she is excited about that move. We are underway in working through the HR process to replace her. That will be a one-year temporary position at Deed, but I start talking now because you have anyone who might be interested in such a thing. We are going to refill that position.
Deanna, did you send out what the spec for that one-year temporary position looks like? Could you do that?
I can do that.
That'd be just, I mean, I think that's helpful when you have it ready because.
Yeah, I might have somebody who'd be interested.
Okay.
I'm really in that role.
Okay. Yeah, in the meantime, compliance type of issue should be directed to you or Diane or both of you?
Yes. Both of us. For
yes.
People who, you know, we don't see regularly, we ask them to use the Deed mailbox because Diane and I both see all the
and
rest of the three of the team.
And
that,
David.
David
Tao is doing a lot of the reimbursement, so.
Yeah, he will continue to do the mechanical pieces.
What's your timeline?
Go to hire.
It's
not approved yet.
I was just going to say, the hire itself is. Yeah, it's working its way through the approval process. It's made it through the first couple of gates. We are hopeful that we can get it done within 2 months. Let me see. The I think that's really that is the main news that we have to announce. I just want to say the treats. We brought the treats to be part of the celebration today of the end of our work, and a thank you because as much as you know, we are not of the task force. We get the opportunity to work with you all throughout the year, and it's been just a pleasure to work with you and be able to benefit from all of your expertise that you all. We have learned so much over the last year in interacting with all of you, and so wanted to say thank you for that. And as we engage, the agency and the administration started to talk about how do we build, you know, look at
mm-hmm.
sustainability for the things that we've started. We're really excited about this next year as you all work to start framing up, you know, what does the next steps of this work look like. And I tell you, just again last week, and we were cited as one of the best set of policy and programs in the country around broadband. And so we are honored to help execute this. The stack that you all helped define and frame up.
Great. Well, thank you. Thank you for the update and the report, and I think also thanks for the information you'll share and ready on the position
mm-hmm.
as well. And that Jane did a good job, and we were lucky to have her for the time we had her. All right. So with the idea that we might go about 20 minutes here, 15 minutes on the first round of this, I just wanted to remind everyone that we are going to produce this report, which is our report that will go to the governor, that also has the audience of the legislature and other policymakers, and then our intention is early next year to start working on an assembly kind of a future-looking report that would go forward for 2018 into 2019, but that it's more future-looking than a as program specific as this report is. So I think just keeping that in mind, we'll talk a little bit about schedule at the end of our meeting today, what I'm proposing for our meeting schedule, which might be a slightly lighter schedule than every single month next year, being that we are in the final year of the task force. But it might be a little dependent if funding, you know, more funding comes through for the grant program or things like that. It could all, that could all change. But I think, you know, thinking about how do we do the best job possible to assemble that future looking report and what types of things we want to highlight. So that we'll see if we have a little time at the end to talk about some of those things. I know committees already have some outlines of issues that, you know, for they let go for this report that would probably come back into play for that next report. I want to compliment everyone around the table for really good work. I think this is, it's come together pretty smoothly here with people giving feedback and commentary, and I think we resolved our final issue earlier this week that we found placement for appropriate sentence that was in debate, and I think we're going to be good to go here, but I think we should probably begin, and we can go for maybe, I'm scared of just getting the technology working, so maybe 15 minutes, and then we'll turn on the TV and see if we can get it on.
What was the
set
sentence?
We'll go to it. You'll see in a moment. We'll highlight it.
Okay.
But it was more the placement of where it was in the report than anything, and I think it went in a much better spot. So, okay, so we begin. I'm certainly happy to take suggestions on the letter if people have them. This was probably, we went through a couple rounds on this, John and I did back and forth about what we, the way we want to say things and the way we want to highlight them in the letter to the government. And I think just what is the ground rule again, you know, if it is a grammatical change or something, make note of it. We don't need to debate every comma or thing here. No. But you know, I think we're looking for the larger scale tone commentary pieces that, you know, they have on the report. But if you do find those, we want to know too. So make note and then we'll assemble them back together. Okay.
Just have one question. Yes. On the letter. Yeah. On the second paragraph, the first clause, it says over the last 2 years, this task force has presented you in the legislature. And I'm just wondering, why do we have 2 years versus some other country?
For the so it's the current task force that I have in mind,
not
previous
task force.
So,
okay.
So I think that's one of the hard parts about this is still we're kind of, you know, we have had, I mean, we could just say, we could leave that out if we find it confusing.
We're saying the current task force.
Yeah.
I mean, the thing that strikes me, if you go to the website, there are reports going back many, many years.
That's why I included this task force.
But
if it's still on,
let's
just
take it out
first.
Yeah. For clarity's sake. So we're on page one and page two. Any other big things? I mean, if you think of them later, we certainly can. Okay. Page three and four. And do we have our sentence here or
it's on page
five? Okay, so this is dense.
I don't know that I actually have a change to advocate for, but the amount of our recommendation, the number jumped out at me as odd, and so I had to kind of dig through the report to figure out where we came with that number, connected that number. So just as an FYI, because it's, I mean, it varied a little bit. It makes sense, once I found it, it made a lot of sense, I remember.
So I think what we have to think about here is, this is the executive summary portion, not the full body of the report, and we don't want to overburden it with detail, but you could footnote it right there for the page that the discussion of that is on, maybe.
Yeah, I'll do that for the other recommendation as well.
Yeah. And that way, at least, because it's probably, a lot of people would read this in electronic version, and then they can go right to it. We'll talk about the calculation of that number when we get to the full section. Okay. Yes?
The last bullet regarding the funding of the Office of Broadband, is it important to note that they also receive funding sources from other agencies that also needs to continue?
How much do you want to highlight the interactions between the other agencies?
Well, something like that.
I don't know. I don't think you've mentioned it in previous reports, and it still gets dealt with at the legislative level.
That's my first reaction,
but something we may want to take a little bit deeper look.
I mean, this funding would be, the point here is, this is ongoing base funding for the operations of the Office of Broadband that we're asking for out of probably general fund monies or some way of funding it. And so I think that's why this number is highlighted in that way, but we should at least look.
And it's been the same as in past reports. So for consistency with past reports, I think this is the same number that was.
But a sentence talking about supporting the continued partnership with the Department of Commerce could be potentially a helpful piece to consider. Like, you don't need to quantify it at this point, but making sure because that's where that came from was deliberation at this table, understanding the value of the partnership between the two agencies, and when it comes into question, making sure that support of that approach is reiterated from this table can be valuable.
Agreed.
So a question I would have about that is the use of the word full funding.
Where are you at?
The recommendation itself, we're on page 3.
Okay, yep.
Full funding, it says. We've talked in the past about making the recommendation that the office receive funding to do some programmatic work as well around adoption. And I'm wondering if the implication is that $250,000 is funding adequate to fulfill all of the many statutory obligations of the office. And maybe if we could just say 200 instead of full funding, 250,000, because the implication is that's adequate to accomplish all of the goals. And in the past, we have called out as a task force that the office be funded to do adoption activities as well.
I think you have agreement. Just
take
out
full.
We'll strike full. Okay. Anything else on page 3? Page 4 kind of starts us into more of the part of this year's report, and I think it would be great if we can get to page 8 by the time we break, and that would be ideal, but if we can't, we can't. So. Page 4. Anything on page 4 that people are striking them, catching them, as we'll move to page 5. So on page 5, I'm looking for a sentence here. So the
talking about a return on investment related tax here. I represented, you know, Alan here. You know, we were thinking that there'd be some shadow boxes, some examples, and but it fits into the narrative just fine here, related to health care. I do, you know, I thought that that set up pretty well there. Just a comment. Okay?
Okay. So if you look at the full third paragraph, not the bullet points, but the paragraphs, we, being able to put the appendix halfway in that paragraph, appendix B contains letters from various stakeholders, including a letter from a group of 24 organizations representing many rural interests that express support for ongoing support of the grant program and the Office of Broadband Development, but raises some concerns, including with the current challenge process, is the sentence I was referring to. Originally, that was in a footnote on page 5 or 6, maybe 7, and then there was debate about whether it goes in the body of the report on that same page, and instead we pulled it forward into the introduction to give it more context, I think, around where things are at. And it points out that that letter is in the appendix for people to look at. So that's what I was referencing.
And so, Margaret, did you say that that, this is Maureen again, did you say that's moving to paragraph 3 of the intro?
It's there, yes, of so, page 5.
Okay.
So, Maureen, there's a new version of the report. Does the report
she has printed? She has it.
Does she have
it? I sent it to her.
Yeah, because I printed an earlier version of it because I was confused.
Okay.
Okay. Well,
are you not seeing that right now?
I thought what was sent out with the meeting.
Diane sent a newer version.
Okay, I'll go over to that.
When did you send it?
I sent it to Kimberly in response to her telling me, Margaret, that Marie wasn't coming. I replied back with the bridge number.
Do you know when you did it, though? It's just helpful.
Around lunchtime yesterday.
Okay, so yesterday around noon, it was sent to Kimberly in your office.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll find it.
Great. All right. We're on page 5 then.
Thoughts people have there?
I feel bad for the observers in the room. This is like watching people like paint a wall or something. I mean, it's just. Okay, if nothing, page 6.
I just had a question.
Yes.
On the last line, the parenthetical that says 6 million of which was carried over. And I'm just wondering if we should say 6.47 because someone who's looking at the numbers carefully would see
find
that.
6.47 or?
Yeah.
What?
You can't say 6.47 because that's just adding the 20 million and the 6.47 and 20 million was the appropriation, but we get to use part of that for administration, so it's really the amount we can award less an amount for administration plus the amount of carryover from the two projects that didn't accept the funding and carryover from 2014 and 2015 projects that finished without using their full contract amount.
So I think Don's saying a different thing, though. He's saying that what was the actual carryover number from?
It was over 6 million because we awarded 26
million.
It
would not be believable that it's exactly 6 million. I think that's your point. So how do we get to?
You say over 6 million would be fine.
Yeah, approximately 6 million, something like that.
A little over.
Yeah, trying to do that math will be more confusing.
Right. The problem is each way, depending on how you slice it, it's going to look a little bit different. And the timing, and so I have to support the more general indication that the number is above that, rather than get specific, because someone's going to pick at it and they're going to consider it inaccurate. That's because we can't get perfectly accurate.
Okay, and that was my concern as to the 6 also,
yes,
that someone would pick at it and say, well, gee, you've got 26.47, 20 million appropriation, So you're saying 6 million, so over or?
Yeah, or drop down the 26 then to, I mean, it, but you could handle it either way. You could say a little over 26 million, or you could say slightly more than 6 million. I mean, you got to say one of the two, because it's not, you know, somebody's going to catch it and be like, what is it?
Diane, were you saying that there was funds from not just last year that were carried over?
Because those have closed out and some of them didn't use all of them.
So essentially 6.47 million carried over from previous years. And
not just from
and
one year.
Plural.
Would that be?
It's, well, it is, except that that assumes we're going to, that we awarded the full 20 million this year, and we don't because we get administrative out of it.
But that doesn't, but that doesn't necessarily
okay.
matter to that sentence.
Okay.
Or to that clause, does it?
You just want the math to add up. This doesn't look right because
okay.
the numbers don't add up. You're
so
missing $470,000.
Right. So, but it probably is more than that. What Diane's saying is it's more like maybe a million.
Right.
So yeah. So I would say, you know, approximately 6 million of which was carried over from
previous
years.
Well, at least 6 million.
No. I don't like, I'd say
approximately.
Because at least could mean 10 million then suddenly.
Yeah.
I'd be careful on it. Scale is important. The word indicates some scale of how much. Good. I mean, I think that's.
And year should be years. Is that right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Or, or you could say previous year. Previous grant years, that might help. Previous grant years, plural. Okay, we'll go to page 7. Anything on page 7 that's not reading well or that people are finding? All right. I'm going to move, if there's nothing on page 8. Oh,
I don't need to bring it back. But on page 7, when they talk about the challenge process again, is there any way to reference the appendix there too in addition to the footnote or no? Or is that we can tie it all in or is that?
I think we don't want to overdo it here. I mean, we've mentioned it, the letter's there. I mean, we're just stating the legislature added a process.
Where are you?
Top of page 7 in the first full paragraph. We're just stating that in 2016, the legislature added a formal challenge process to the grant program, and then we cite the statute. I think this is really the fact.
I think this is where we it had originally
right
been.
Then.
And,
we
and it was moved
oh,
from here.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to move a recess, and we're going to try to see if we can find this.
Okay.
Think back for the Hallmark Channel.
The Hallmark Channel.
Pardon?